Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We've got two teams here looking to find a way to win. It's the Dolphins coming in at 4-9, going up against the Chiefs, who come in at 3-10.
Larry, we could have been assigned to December games in Buffalo, Pittsburgh, Cleveland. Instead, we get the plum assignment here in sunny Miami, Florida. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Kansas City Chiefs, and he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And the Miami Dolphins. First carry now for Kareem Hunt. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Okay, there's a tone setter. First play from scrimmage. Stuff him in the backfield.
You know what they were doing last night in the hotel room? Visualizing exactly that. That's what they were thinking about. Making that play. Having leverage lower than the offensive lineman. Getting into the offensive backfield, knocking someone down. Just what you said, set the tone early for this game.
Jeez, you are fired up.
When I see a play like that, I can't help it.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. Yeah, the movement there coming from the middle of the line.
And you understand he wants to get off the ball quickly. But the ball's right in front of him. He has to watch it move first.
Bridgewater now on second down. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position. Couldn't hold on. Third down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Third and long for Bridgewater. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 45. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. Now a stoppage here as it looks like we've got a Dolphin shaking up on the play. We'll get an update when we come back to Miami. They'll run for the first time with Johnson. And oh, his first carry, he loses the football. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds.
I don't know about you, but I can hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. Ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession, no turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. Finding room to the 20. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Partner, it's often the man coverage is easier for a quarterback to run against. You get your receivers going downfield. Those guys are staying with them, and oftentimes they have their back to the quarterback, which opens up a lot of space and room, and they don't even know that he's taken off with it. What a big-time pickup on that play.
They'll run it with Johnson, and he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. David Johnson with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Chiefs are going to take a first quarter lead. Roberto Aguayo now for the point after. And his kick is good to make it 7-0 KC. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. Out comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here.
You know, in our research packet this week prepping for the game, so many articles from the local beat writer about the offensive struggles of this team and what will they do this offseason. What do you think they'll do?
Well, number one, they'll turn to their self-scouting report. And every team that's any good does this. They have outside groups check out their team, scout them, and tell you who can play, who can't play, and reasons why. Some of it may just be health. They have to get some guys healthy and back out on the field. But overall, evaluate this squad and make the changes that you need to.
Second down now after the pass completion. They'll run. This is Hunt. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action and hit them over the top.
On third down, Bridgewater. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's James. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Just a 5-yard pickup, but it leads to fourth down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
And now here comes Kansas City.
And they'll be looking to make this a two-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their first drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up two scores here on the road. That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing, and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did something of that.
And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. On second down, Johnson. And he'll get only a couple up to the 22.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Now back to throw. Throw left side complete. That's Hoffman. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Chiefs first down. Now a play fake here on first down. Rolling to his right. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
Oh, my goodness. Was that a defensive back that got to him with the pressure?
Oh, look at the former defensive back. You're all smiles up here.
I hope everybody can hear my smile on that play.
On play action, they'll throw. Being chased out left. Give him 15 yards on that one. Kansas City has a first down.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. As the Chiefs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter. So the offense has it first and 10. Back to throw. Screen play, Johnson. He doesn't find a ton of space following the display of quick feet down just inside the 45. Only three there on the screen. It's second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Out of the pistol, here's Johnson. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
So third and five, defensively expecting pass. They've got six DBs out there. This is Whitaker, and they went the wrong way there, losing yardage. Back at the 43-yard line. It'll be a loss of one, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. Here's Brad Wing now to punt it away on fourth down. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over.
And this is their third drive right now. Maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
Accelerating and off he goes. He's at the 50. 30. The 20, 10, and on the way in for a Miami touchdown. A big play there, taking it goal line, 100 yards. And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying up this football game. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This is Fielded at the goal line. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field.
And, you know, their previous possession, they were able to move the football but still wound up punting in the end.
You know, in 2016, Carolina had a 20-play drive that lasted over 10 minutes. And remember how it ended?
In a punt.
Yeah, I mean, how does that happen? You just don't see that happen every day.
This one maybe not quite that bad, but still, you'd like to have a chance for points if you hold the football that long.
Agreed.
And, oh, Johnson dinged up a bit. Still down. Hopefully nothing serious. We'll get an update when we come back to Hard Rock Stadium. They'll set up a throw. Escaping the pressure right. He'll hit Whitaker in the flat. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
The give to Whitaker. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. It'll go as a gain of 10 and a Kansas City first down.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
Second down now after the incompletion. He'll look to throw. And this is incomplete.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Back to throw here. Eluding the pressure right. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 30. And he's able to bring it out 5 yards shy of midfield to the 45-yard line. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll get an update when we come back to Miami. They'll begin the drive with Hunt. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient. Followed his blocks. Develop and then burst through for big gains.
And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. Looking left side and he's got a man. It's Shepard. So close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run. 51 yards. An update from Buffalo. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. That one tight to this point, and you'd have to imagine it'll stay tight throughout. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We'll come back to Miami after this. First down and goal. The offense knocking on the door. They come out here in the eye. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Home. Only a yard that time. Second and goal.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get his second touchdown already.
And he will score. Touchdown, Miami. Teddy Bridgewater, his first touchdown of the year. And the Dolphins have taken the lead.
That was not a designed run. It was supposed to be a pass, but it turned into an exceptional run. What a scramble for a touchdown.
Elliott now to add the extra point. He's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Flushed out right. Space to maneuver at the 40. He finds Corey Davis. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. He got 29 yards that time. They go play action here on first down. Buying time to his left. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he gets his down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. 2nd down and just 1. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Back to throw now on first down. Oh, he can't hang on. That was a dream chance for any D lineman to possibly get a pick. But instead, it falls down incomplete. Ten yards still left on second down. Here's Whitaker. Dances by him. And some space here. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. A great effort there. His 4th touchdown on the year. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Aguayo on for the PAT. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Then the Dolphins getting set to go here. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
Throwing on first down, Sloan. Throw left side complete. It's James. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. On first and 10. Sloan, flush to his right, on the run, he'll let this go deep right, that's caught inside the 20, powering his right, and all the way in for a Miami touchdown, Sterling Shepard, his 5th touchdown now on the year, and the Dolphins strike quickly here for 6 points.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. And the Chiefs now getting set to go. There have been points on the board. We just saw back-to-back touchdown drives. I love it. I'm high-fiving our statistician, Christian McLeod, and you're angry. You're a defensive guy.
If you met one of my defensive coordinators, God rest his soul, I'm surprised he isn't in this booth right now wanting to really take you on. This is not football the way he sees it. He wants
him.
A good old-fashioned kicking game, defense, field position, and we're getting an up and down the field game here.
I'll take him. Where's his tombstone?
Boot Hill, baby.
And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. That one a broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
A play action fake. They'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
Around the NFL, they're in the second in Philly. It's the Lions that have grabbed the early lead. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor. Here's a play fake as they set up the throw. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42.
Partner, I know the ball security's preached like crazy, but every now and then you've got to know when to get rid of the football and save a little bit of yardage if you're a quarterback.
Because now if you're the offensive coordinator, what does it do if it was third and 10 versus third and much longer as it is now?
Yeah, it changes everything in terms of play calling and the pressure you might expect to face on the very next down. Had to throw the ball away and save the yardage. He didn't get it done.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of his first half of play. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Fresh set of downs here. Looking to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's going to be run over, hit hard, as he'll be marked down.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. Now a handoff here to his running back. And not even back to the line of scrimmage this time as they're on him quickly once more. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and 11. He'll drop to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Hoffman. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. First down for the Chiefs. Solid chunk of yardage. 17 on the play. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. They'll drop the throw. Escaping the pressure right. Gonna throw right side here. Complete. And he'll go down at the 28. Now after the completion, we're gonna get a timeout. An injured player. We'll get an update when we come back to Hard Rock Stadium. 4 yards remaining now on second down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. And he'll give it here to his running back. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and 4. The Chiefs on third down. 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 4. They're going to look to throw. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there. That brings up 4th. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, but the net gain, 3 points.
And you're going to have drives like that in this league. Sometimes you just got to take the 3 and move on. Always better than nothing.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. So here are the Dolphins now. They get ready for their first possession of the second half. First down, Sloan. Throw left side, complete. It's Shepard, and he'll go out of bounds across the 35-yard line. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Diggs in motion left. Now Hunt, and an alley to run. Room to run past midfield, and taking it across midfield and inside the 45. That good for 19 and a first down.
Now this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
They'll bring a receiver in motion left. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Hunt, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
to throw on second down. Sloan. Incomplete. They were trying to get it there to Sterling Shepard, and it'll bring up third down.
My good friend, I'm just going to pose the question to you. Did that look like a pass that he should have thrown?
Now, the rookie probably needs to be a little bit more careful in these situations.
Yeah, that throw would turn him into a veteran quicker, but not in the way that he wants. He wants to learn his lessons by making good throws, not throws like that.
Back to throw. Sloan. It's caught. Shepard. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Dolphins first down. Throwing on first down. Sloan. And Diggs has it. A nice gain of 21 yards. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. A great play there.